So now, as we said, we're now going to add some anti-spam measures, and we're going to use a technique called the honeypot. To understand how this works, you need to understand how these registration bots actually work. What they'll do is they will scan your form. They will pick up the names of all of the inputs within that form, and then they will substitute or create values to input into them. And in a lot of cases, they don't actually run the form. All they do is they pass the input data directly to your server action. So your server action processes their information and stores it in the database. And main reason they do that is they want to find sites where they can inject adverts and things like that. So what we need to do is look at how we're going to stop that. Now, if you think the process that I said, what they said was they scan for inputs, they populate them, and then they send that information to your action. So what we're going to do is we're going to create, first of all, a input which will have no value, and also we expect not to be created or have content within our server action. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into a registration form, and all I'm going to do here is I'm going to add a very simple text input. A text input we will call, let's say, product ID. Obviously nothing to do with products, this is just purely so if the spam bot is intelligent and can register, you know, recognize certain names as being obvious honeypots, it wouldn't find a product ID registration sort of form input to be unusual. And we're going to make that a hidden one because we really don't want the user to be able to see that. Save that. If we go back into our server action now, our API action, back into our inputs, we can import from form again. We can actually delete that password too. Save that. We now have product ID in there. Don't worry that those validation messages have disappeared. That does sometimes happen within Wappler. I'll show you they're still there. We're going to add an action now after you've validated the input, because if the email's already there, we don't need to worry about it. We're going to add a condition in. That condition we will find within core actions. And we're going to add condition. And that condition is going to be that post product ID must be empty. Now, you can generally get away with just saying post product ID or not post product ID to be more correct. But I like to go a little bit further and just check its length. So what we can do is within collections, if I remember rightly. No, it will actually be text, my apologies. Length. So if the length of that is greater than zero, in other words, it has content. If it has content because the length is greater than zero, then we're going to do something. What are we going to do? We're going to send back an unauthorized response to our page. And that doing that will then stop the processing, so it will never get to the stage where it's looking at the password validation and the inputs. And again, we can find that within core actions, and we call that action, or pick that action, the component response. We give it a name, that's just a friendly name. An unauthorized response from a server action would be a 401 response. If you're not sure about server response codes, just pop them into Google. Google exactly that, server response codes, and it will give you a list of all the different response codes that a server may return. And optionally, you can also add a text message which could be displayed I'll put that in, but we're not actually going to display it. Just simply say unauthorized. So now our action will check that, see whether anything's been put into that product ID field. And if something has been put into that product ID field, it effectively will abort the processing action, and it will then return the back to the form, and we will get an error. So let's save that. And we can actually simulate that with a little cheat. We can simulate that by giving that a value which it shouldn't have. So this will trick the API action to thinking that somebody has falsified the information. And now if we just make sure everything's saved first, if I fire up that register page, I'm just going to stick test at page.com. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We've read our terms and conditions. Register. You see there, it's come back with an unauthorized message because it believes that that checkout has been tampered with. So that's our most basic honeypot. But we can actually make that a little more sophisticated now by adding a populated honeypot. So let's have a look at that in my next module to follow immediately.